Let's go back to where we were yesterday on take 10. The archers have sorely grieved him. Now, this is after he said a whole lot of things. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on it. We'll come back and talk about it a little bit later. But he said to Reuben, "You're my firstborn." And then he says, "You're unstable as water." There's a whole lot of other things he said, but I don't want to take my time with you just in this little 10 minutes of instruction and excitement. I don't want to take that time. Simeon and Levi gave them the thing. He said, "You're instruments of cruelty to your habitation." Judah talks about being a lion's whelp and good things, and the scepter will not depart from him. You're going to have rulership. Zebulun will dwell at the haven of the sea. Issachar, he said he was a strong donkey crouching between two burdens. Dan's going to be the judge. Gad has a troop that will overcome him, but Gad will overcome at last. That was a kind of a wake-up call. Asher, the bread's going to be fat. He's going to yield royal dainties. Going to cook up some good stuff. Naphtali is a hind let loose, and he gives goodly words. And he comes to Joseph, and he just says Joseph is a fruitful bough. He's a fruitful tree, even a fruitful tree by a well, whose branches run over the wall. But then he lays it out, just like you and I can know it. The archers have sorely grieved him and shot him and hated him, but his bows abode in strength, and the arms of his hands were made strong. The arms of his hands, hold on to that, by the hands of the mighty God of Jacob, from thence is the shepherd, the stone of Israel, or is Christ. And just one more, Benjamin. Wow, he says Benjamin's going to be like a wolf. He's going to hunt and devour the prey, but at night, Benjamin is going to divide the spoil. And if you look at it later, you'll see that Benjamin found the attributes of being a Joseph, but protecting what he had and how to reap the surviving power and authority of God. I'm studying today, and I want you to study with me. But nothing can be so precious as we go back and look at this scene. And just what I've talked to you about, think about it. The bedside of Jacob on his final day. It must have been a fine sight to see Jacob sitting in his bed while he bestowed his parting benediction upon these 12 sons. I've mentioned some of the meat of what he said. Now, Jacob had been noble in many instances in his life, like the sleeping place at Bethel where the ladder came from heaven. And he climbed and climbed and wrestled and wrestled and wrestled until it left him with a limp. We could talk about the brook of Jabbok. We could talk about the halting of Peniel. He had been a glorious man, but his closing scene was possibly the absolute best. Looking upon his son Reuben, there was a tear in his eye. He recollected Reuben's sin. He passed over Simon and Levi, gave some slight rebuke. And on others, he sung a verse of praise as he saw into the future history of their tribes. But by and by, his voice began to fail him. And this good old man, with long-drawn breath, with eyes pregnant with celestial fire, and a heart big with heaven, he lifted his voice to God and he said, "I have waited for my salvation, thy salvation, O God." Waiting to die, waiting to go to another world. He rested for a moment on his pillow, and then again he sat up, recommenced the strain. He paused briefly by the names of each. But when he came to Joseph, and we're going to spend the next few days talking about what happened here. Because it's happening to you. It's happening to you every day. And some people just don't realize they have to take up the shield of faith. And then they have to put out the fiery darts of the enemy that are coming against them. And it's not flesh and blood that we fight. Yes, it will be flesh and blood that will put in you. I have arrows in me that if I were to allow them will start fire today. But every time somebody blows on the embers of that, I see a picture. I see a this. I see a that. I see a Facebook post. I see someone preaching somewhere. I see an advertisement. An old flame starts burning. I have the obligation to my idea, my vision, my dream to quench that fiery dart, to put that out, because my life is so important and yours is so important to do what God has called you to do. Picture this old man, the tears running down his face as his mind is flooded with the memories of what happened in Joseph's life. You see, he saw Joseph as a prince. He saw Joseph with all his mother Rachel in his eyes. It was the dearly beloved wife of his. Now standing before him, he was the boy for whom the mother had prayed for with all the eagerness of an Eastern wife. And for a long 20 years, she had carried a barren woman and was a joyful mother. And now she calls her son Increase. 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 Look, let's stop a minute and talk about you. In the new birth, God says he knows the thoughts he has about you. They are good and not of evil. They're not a fiery dart to knock you back. They're not holding you back. They're the good thoughts are to push you forward. Satan's whole joy in life is to take over the thought pattern, and he'll do it with friends, enemies. He'll do it with a dog if he can. I remember one time I was being blessed with a piece of property, and the word of the Lord had come to me and had told me several years older that you will know you're at this piece of property that I am to give you. When you get out of the car, on the ground, there will be a prophet just speaking to me in a backwoods place of Bonwear, Texas. And he said, on the ground, there will be a sack. And it will be like a Dairy Queen sack or a Carl sack or some little sack there. There'll be a sack on the ground. Now, this happened some 35 years ago, but I can tell you, I went my life looking for that. And that day, he said, you will be with an old man, and before you get to the joy, you will have an attack. We got out of the car. I saw exactly, and my whole mind was flooded with that prophetic dream, that vision, that speaking, that idea that I had been carrying for so long. And I said, could this be the place I've been looking for? I was in a desperate place. It seems like guys like me always stay in a place moving forward, always attacking, always going. I don't have time for a lot of this and that that men do. I don't know where they find time to do all that they do in their own flesh. God bless them. In me, I'm always going forward. Even in my semi-retirement, I'm going forward trying to capture another land, another place, another glory. But there we opened the little gate to the house that sat on the top of the hill over all of this property that was to be mine on the freeway. And out from the side of the house came running a dog, knocked the old man down. The young prophet that was with me immediately began to fight that dog with the shovel that was laying nearby and chased that mean dog away. And before we got back in the car, the old man stuck out his hand and shook me, and he said, you write the paper, I will sign that paper, and I will make it work for you. I will bear the burden of this land. May I tell you, there's some ideas and visions coming your way, but there's a lot of dream killers. During that time, I had everybody telling me, la, 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 la. It just doesn't matter what all the sayings are that come in your head. They're fiery, boil it down. They are fiery darts of the enemy coming to quench you. But if you've gone far enough to have a boy named Increase, you're going to need to protect it. Today, get ready. Somewhere, there'll be a battle. Win the battle, you'll find your way to Increase. Survive that dream killer today. Tomorrow, let's go in there and talk about how much Jacob loved him and how much your father God loves you. Now, he was sitting there looking at him. His lover Rachel was gone, long buried under the cold sod. But now he saw the future redeemers right before him. And I'm looking through this camera, and I'm talking to you on podcast, and I'm talking to you all through emails and whatever messages out there. And I'm telling you, I know there are many Josephs in front of and listening to the sound of my voice. Get up, get the shield, quench the darts, and move forward until you come to a child called increase. God bless you. See you next time.